What's up, guys? If you're observing everything right, you can see that we're here in the Griffith Observatory today, bringing you guys a new episode of FJU TV. Make sure you guys stick around. We have a lot in store. Jocelyn, what are we going to show today?
Well, I think you're going to have to wait, no? Yeah. Okay, you got to wait. Okay, but guys, Before we get started, we need to mention our social networks. You can find us and follow us on Facebook and on Instagram, and as well as on Snapchat, guys. Come on, hit us up.
What are you guys waiting for? Take a selfie and send it over, all right, guys? So make sure you guys stick around. My name is Joseph.
My name is Jocelyn.
And you guys are watching
FJU TV.
Born and raised under the rain and a western wind, felt the weight, trying to live up to the say I am. Is it any wonder? Shame comes calling my first name. Is there any question if I'm the one he left to blame? It's the same fight all over again. It's the same vibe breaking on my skin. It's the same light when you let me in. You let me in. You let me in.
Welcome back to FJU TV. So we're here once again at the Griffith Observatory. As you can see, we have a very interesting topic, and the topic is today is about patience. Have you been in a situation where you're like, oh my gosh, like
Six Flags?
Yeah. When you, oh my gosh, those 2-hour waiting lines. Oh my goodness. Okay. Yeah. So there's a lot of situations in our life where we have to wait in a really long line, or we have to wait, and sometimes we get really impatient, and there's people that throw tantrums, there's people that do crazy things because, you know, they're really sick and tired of waiting, and, you know,
they attack you, you shortcut them.
Yeah,
exactly. Anyways, all right, guys, well, The next segment that we're going to have today is one of the crowd favorites. Make sure you guys have your helmets on because your mind's going to be blown because it's time for
What's Up With Ernie?
We'll be right back, guys. Stick around. Hello, guys, and welcome to the What's Up With Ernie segment here from the Griffith Observatory. We are here, as you guys have already heard, and there's beautiful views. I can see everything, guys. Like, this is beautiful. So, guys, today our topic is patience, as you guys have already heard from Jocelyn and Joseph. And, well, I want to share with you guys a Bible verse from Hebrews 10:36, which says, "You need to be patient in order to do the will of God and receive what He promised." You see, guys, even in our spiritual life, patience plays a big role. And our physical lives here, you know, and our everyday life, it plays a role as well. If you guys live here in LA, you guys know how packed the 405 is. You know how packed lots of restaurants can be. The wait for some of the things here, it can be really long, you know. So patience is a really important thing. And for my facts, well, I wanted to share with you guys how long some people have had to wait in order to get out of a traffic jam. The world's largest traffic jam was recorded in Beijing, China, and it lasted for 60 miles, and it took people 11 days to get out of that traffic jam. So you guys can imagine, 11 days stranded in a traffic jam. How, that would be terrible. I honestly wouldn't take that. Like, not, the radio plays so much music repetitively, and I couldn't, guys. And also, did you guys know that moviegoers in the 1970s waited for 3 hours just to see the Star Wars movie? I mean, Star Wars is cool and all, but I would not wait 3 hours to watch Star Wars. I mean, respect to all the Star Wars lovers out there, but I don't know, guys. You know, but guys, may the force be with you for this week. I really appreciated the opportunity to be here and to say hi to you guys, to be here another week. So God bless you guys. May God bless your week and see you next week on What's Up With Ernie.
Welcome back to FJU TV. Now, today we're gonna switch things up and we're gonna have like a one-on-one discussion and basically about the topic that we have today, which is patience. And a lot of times, you know, in our life, we do wait for a lot of things, you know, but it's like physical things, you know, like Black Friday, you know, like on the rides, you know, things like that. Or like we wait for like when we're like waiting for something to happen. Yeah. And a lot of things you can, a lot of times you can apply that spiritually speaking. So when you're, you know, waiting for that blessing from God, you know, when you're waiting to receive the Holy Spirit, waiting to receive, you know, something that you always, that you are fighting for, and you have to be patient, you know, because it's not our will, it's His will, you know. He has timing, and our timing is a lot different than ours. Really different. Like we think that sometimes a lot, like I remember this because I remember back in my times when I first started, you know, coming, participating after you, you know, I was expecting God to be like a genie, you know, like someone that's like, yeah, what do you want? Like what do you want? And then I would say, okay, I want this, I want that. And it'll be like, and then that's what I thought. Like it was just like something like magic. It was like magic, like out of thin air. But I came to realize that that's not really the case, you know, that you have to be patient. You have to be like, okay, like, you know, continue on persevering. I think that's the main key, is being persevering, you know, being, having that vision, like always believe that you're going to receive it, even though it might take, you know, months, years, but it will happen, you know. It's having that faith, using your faith to believe that. And that's, a lot of people don't have that because they're impatient. They're easily impatient, just how they wait in the line, like they're waiting on the line with God, and they get really impatient. So yeah,
I think it's really important, you know, like you said, everything takes time, you know. And sometimes, like you said, we want God to be like a genie, you know, but the thing is that God gives us, you know, what we need at the time. You know, for example, you might be like 15, 16, and you're asking God to send you your husband, you know?
Yeah.
And you might get really impatient, but the thing is, you know, it's not the right time, you know, and God sees that. Maybe at the moment we don't, but God's like, you know what, no, you're going to have to wait, you know? And
because you don't even have a job, yeah, you don't like, even know what you want to do.
You're a little like, kid, you know?
Yeah.
So I think that it's very hard sometimes, you know? Because the thing is that you don't have a date, like, okay, this is a day that you're going to receive this, and then next week you're going to get this other thing. Like, no, it's a matter of, like, of believing, you know, and having that certainty that your blessing will arrive, you know, no matter what it is, whether it's a blessing, you know, in your career or a blessing in your sentimental life, a blessing in your spiritual life. It's just trusting God's word and believing He'll keep His promise. And staying patient, you know, because once you start getting desperate, once you start getting anxious, it's when we make a lot of mistakes, you know. We go looking to find the things ourselves, and a lot of times, you know, we end up messing up, you know, and making the wrong decisions because we weren't patient. So it's definitely something really important for everyone to have and for everyone to try to receive, you know, which is that patience that we all need. So guys, if you guys have any questions, comments, if you guys, you know, find yourself to relate to this, or maybe you guys went through something like this, you know, where you were really impatient, you got anxious, and then you end up making a mistake. You know, if you guys want to share your stories, whatever it is, you guys can always send it to our Dropbox. Jocelyn, what is it?
It's our email, actually, and it's at tv@fjuniversal.com. Also, you can call or text us. Maybe you have so much anxiety that you need to talk to someone. You know, you need to look for someone to guide you. You can always call or text at 323-510-7358. Once again, that's 323-510-7358.
All right, guys, we'll be right back with our questions and answers segment. Make sure you guys stick around. We'll be right back with more, okay? And we'll also be introducing... Hello guys, and welcome to another episode of FJU TV. As you guys can see, we're here today in beautiful Santa Monica. And...
Hold
on guys, I feel like I'll be... Hello guys, and we're here in the Southern California Rose Garden. Yeah.
That was
you know what it is? It's what's up with
their...
No,
that's...
Two, and go.
How do you know someone might be a little vain?
Well, I think one of the first clues would be that person's really insecure, no? Because...
Bro,
oh,
what?
My...
What?
Yell with me after...
Hello guys, and this week's topic is going to be all about music.
Let's go.
Two.
Hey. Thank you, Griselli, for being here with us.
Well, Justin, has anybody ever like salted you or anything? Hello, guys. And this week's topic is gonna. Hello guys, and welcome to What's Up with Ernie here from LACMA. Oh my god! Alright guys, welcome back, and today we're going to be having a really special guest. You guys might have seen him on TV here and there, but he's going to be telling us a little bit about his story, so make sure you guys don't move.
What?
It's time for, let me check my mic, it's time for What's Up With Ernie, guys.
And
I'm good, you know, I'm happy. I have a good job, have a good car. Everybody tells me, you know, I always have a smile on my face, but sometimes, you know, when I'm alone, I get these thoughts of just wanting to jump.
We'll be right back. right, guys, so welcome to our questions and answers segment of the show. The first question goes out to our friend Jocelyn. Jocelyn, why is patience so important?
Patience is super important because, you know, it leads to us of how the decisions, the problems, you know, in our everyday life, when someone's very impatient, when someone's very anxious, when someone's really frustrated, they do a lot of, they solve like their problems, but they go based on what they feel, you know, yeah. They go based on their heart, based on what they feel, and you know, they lead to that, you know, and that's what, when they go through problems and they use their heart and they use their emotions, they're just gonna go rock bottom, like they're gonna go like towards what they didn't want to go. And when someone is patient, when someone stops and analyzes, okay, what do I have to do, okay, what do I have to do to solve this problem, you know, it'll come out 10 times better. Because why? Because they were being patient, they were analyzing their problem, they were analyzing their situation, they would be like, okay, now I know what to do, you know.
Yeah, that's very true, you know. I think it's very important, you know, like you said, because a lot of times if you're not patient, you just crash and burn.
Seriously. Okay, and the second question is, what's the difference between a person who is in their comfort zone and then someone who's patient?
I think there's a big difference between those two, but it's something that's very easy to get confused. I always think about, like, being in your comfort zone is like patience to the max, you know? Like, you're, I don't even know, like, you overdosed on patience because, for example, I see it like, okay, maybe you have a goal you want to reach, you know, you have a certain career you want to have, a certain position or something like that, and maybe you get a job, you know, and, you know, you're working, you get comfortable, and you get in your comfort zone, and then you're like, you know what, I'm fine here, there's no need for me to move up or strive for something better. Well, if you're patient, you're like, okay, I'm right here, but I'm going to keep on working towards my goal. You know, I'm not going to rush into it and make a mistake, but I'm going to work little by little and make sure that I get there. You know, I'm not going to stay in my comfort zone. I'm not going to, you know, stay here for 5 years. No, I'm going to set goals for myself and reach them, you know. So I think that's a difference, you know. Settling down or moving forward, even if it's, you know, slowly, but, you know, you get to your goal. So, like, an overdose on patience, so make sure you guys are careful.
And the last question is, when is the time to be revolted? Like, when is the time to be like, no, I don't accept being in this situation. No, I don't accept, you know, struggling through this problem for many years and I'm not able to find a situation. So, when is the time to revolt?
I think, like, it goes back to, like, the comfort zone thing, you know? When you, a situation has been like that, you know, like you said, for too long, like, You have the goal you want to reach, but it's been a long time. You haven't been able to get close to it. Maybe you haven't reached that goal yet. So it's time what? It's time to start moving, you know? It's time to get, you know, the waters flowing, you know? You have to work, like I said, being patient, you know, not rushing into things, but you have to not accept the situation you're in. You know, if you see, you set a goal, okay, by next year, I want to have, you know, my own company. But you see that nothing has happened, then what? You have to start working, you know, start working. Make sure you revolt against the situation. What do you think, Justin?
Yeah, and I think it's having that, you know, moment and to analyze and be like, wait a minute, like, I've been through this problem for many years, or like, I have a goal, like you said, like, I have a goal to do something, or like, to get him a degree, to do something, and time is flying by, and next thing you know, it's 2016, like in a couple months. So, and then you think yourself, okay, the plans that I have for 2015, like, I haven't done anything, like squat. And then you're like, soon we're approaching 2016 and you're like, wait, it's like been like already like more than half of the year and I haven't done anything. Then that's the difference, and that's the time when you need a revolt. That's the time when you need to take initiative and take that action and take that decision and be like, you know what, I'm not gonna accept being in starting the next year, you know, in the same situation. No, I'm gonna, it's a matter of you wanting to, you know? God can do so many things, but it's up to you. Like, it really comes down to you. Like, how you are, like, how you are revolted, you know, God's gonna see that, and you're gonna call the attention from him, and that's how you get your blessing, you know?
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, that was our question and answer segment for today, and unfortunately, that's the end of the show.
I know, you guys.
But... the good thing is that we'll be back next week, so make sure you guys check us out next week. Also, who knows where we'll be exploring the wonderful California, you know, so make sure you guys stick around. And remember, don't overdose on patience, you know, make sure you stay balanced. All right, so that was it for today, guys. My name is Joseph.
My name is Jocelyn.
And you guys are watching
FJU TV. Bye.